In this video, we're going to approximate the speed of an electron that's orbiting in a hydrogen atom. And we're using a naive classical model for this. So we're pretending the electron is just orbiting the proton with an orbit of a diameter equal to 1 angstrom, the approximate diameter of the hydrogen atom. When we look at atomic physics later on, we're going to find out that it's actually a lot more complicated than this, but this is a good first approximation and a good chance to review uniform circular motion. So again, the diameter of the atom is 1 angstrom, or 10 to the negative 10 meters, which means the radius of the orbit is going to be half that. The charge magnitude on the proton is plus QE plus the elementary charge here. And the charge magnitude on the electron is the same thing, but it comes with a minus sign. Because the proton is positive and the electron is negative, the force between them is, of course, attractive. And the magnitude of that force is given by Coulomb's law, and it points to the center of curvature, which is good because we have a circular motion problem. And that force is going to cause the electron to accelerate to the center of curvature. In other words, it's a centripetal acceleration that curves the path of the electron into a circle. So I'm going to solve this problem in a totally symbolic way before we plug in any numbers. And it starts with Newton's second law. I did specify up in the problem that we're justified in saying the proton is basically stationary because it's so much more massive than the electron. So we have this stationary center, and what I'm talking about here with Newton's second law is the net force on the electron and the acceleration of the electron. So what's the net force on the electron? It's given by Coulomb's law. So K times the magnitude of each of the charges divided by the distance between them squared. Now notice here that I just ignored the minus sign on the electron's charge. And that's because I'm defining the inward direction as the positive direction for this problem. So I'm going to have a positive force because it points inward, and my acceleration will be treated as positive as well because it's also center pointing, and that's the positive direction for my coordinate system. The mass that's accelerating, that's the mass of the electron, and the acceleration of the electron, well, that's a centripetal acceleration. It's given by v squared over r. So cleaning things up a little, I can cancel one factor of r, and I get k qe squared over me times r is equal to v squared. And finally, I can solve for v, and that's k qe squared over the mass of the electron times the radius of the orbit. So there's our symbolic solution, and we'll wrap things up by plugging some numbers into that. And remember, we're talking about half the diameter of the hydrogen atom here. So I'm going to write that as 0.5 times 10 to the negative 10. Now, unless otherwise indicated, I normally just round things to 3 sig figs. So I've got 2.25 times 10 to the sixth meters per second. Again, we know that electrons actually move in orbitals where the position is smeared out in a probability wave. But this sort of naive classical view of the hydrogen atom is going to come back when we study the Bohr atom. We just have to make some adjustments by using quantum mechanics. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.